WLS-FM, Chicago.
Here's news from American FM Radio. Another flare-up in Belfast, Northern Ireland tonight, even though British troops are on duty trying to keep the peace between Catholics and Protestants. One British soldier was wounded by sniper fire. Seven people are now known dead, many hurt in the trouble in Belfast. Correspondent Richard Whitmore of the BBC is in Belfast and gives this description of the situation tonight.
There's another outbreak of shooting in the Hooker Street area of Belfast. That's close to where the troops are on duty. And in Cooper Street, sealed off by the army, a battle is going on between rival factions throwing petrol bombs at one another. So it looks from here as though the situation has got slightly worse.
Richard Whitmore of the BBC, monitored by ABC News here in New York. This is David Garcia in New York.
The greatest thing that could possibly happen to you this summer is happening right now. It's happening at every Buick showroom. It's the Buick Summer Sell-Down. And it's everything its name implies. Everything. The Buick Summer Sell-Down. It's the best time of the year to choose your favorite 1969 Buick. You name it. Skylark, Special Deluxe, Sportwagon, Riviera, LeSabre, Wildcat, Electra 225. Equip the way you want it equipped. Priced just right for you. Never has there been a better selection of 1969 Buicks for you to choose from. The Buick Summer Sell-Down. Never has there been a finer selection of Buick deals. Your Buick dealer's Summer Sell-Down. It's the start of a great summer. Wouldn't you really rather have a Buick?
Hurricane Camille is now reported moving across the western tip of Cuba, packing winds of 115 miles an hour. Radio Havana says hundreds of people have been evacuated from the lowlands of South Pinar del Rio province. Over 10 inches of rain fell on the Isle of Pines, just south of mainland Cuba. Those two rail shipments of phosgene gas bought by chemical companies from the Army. One is being detained in northeast Ohio because of complaints of potential danger. The other is moving slowly to its destination in Louisiana. Congressman Richard McCarthy of New York is one person complaining about the shipment. McCarthy says
80% of the casualties in World War I were from a phosgene gas. It is a lethal gas. Lethal quantities are 1,600 milligrams per minute per cubic meter. It would kill you in a matter of minutes.
And McCarthy says public safety is being made secondary to economics. The phosgene gas being held up in Ohio was going to a chemical company in Lockport, New York. Alan Vandemark owns that company and maintains the gas is not a nerve gas. Vandemark says,
it's certainly a poor way to seek political publicity when you're trying to scare people and panic them about a product that either you know better or you know nothing about. I think it's just the wrong kind of politics.
And Vandemark says phosgene gas is used in making a number of products, including some drugs. In South Vietnam tonight, enemy troops reported moving across the Cambodian border, mounting several ground attacks against U.S. outposts north of Saigon and in Saigon. At least 37 other enemy raids reported in the fifth day of the new enemy offensive. The school district of Crosby, Texas, near Houston, is on the receiving end of a suit filed by the Justice Department. The suit charges the Crosby School District has not ended desegregation in its public schools. This is news from American FM Radio. The Federal Reserve Board says industrial production in the U.S. jumped 0.7% last month. That sets a new high based on the 1957-59 average. A report that Israeli and Egyptian troops traded fire again tonight across the Suez Canal. The Popular Front for the Liberation of Palestine is now saying only al-Fatah commandos pulled a raid early this morning in Israel's port of Haifa. Both Arab groups had claimed credit. Explosions blew up an oil pipeline and knocked down power lines in the port of Haifa. In London tonight, Russian author Anatoly Kuznetsov said he defected to Britain because, as he put it, Russia is like a prison. And Kuznetsov said Russian censors distorted everything he wrote. Britain granted Anatoly Kuznetsov asylum on July 30th. From New York, this is David Garcia. And this has been news from the American FM Radio Network. Good night. A service of ABC News.
There is nothing in the city of Chicago quite like insanity of Piper's Alley, except perhaps Insanity South. We like to call them the stores you experience.
Everything we do is music.
By Ian Whitcomb, and we had the moving sound of the Stomp first by 10 Years After.
Before I was born, there was a flower, and the flower was called a rose, and it grew wild and free, and it became a savage, the savage rose in the plain on Polydor Records. Hottest rock group, The Savage Rose, in the plain, now available on Polydor Records, is here. And it's the happiness of God's little hand. If you can dig it, you'll find it at a record store near you, and you will find yourself born again.
Of Martha Reeves and the Vandellas for Vista. This country is in trouble. Too many people have been stepped on for too long, and they're getting tired of it. If America really means all those words about equality and about liberty and justice for all, we better start proving it. Vista volunteers spend a year full-time, not just just studying the problems or forming some committee, but really getting to know the people and helping to see what's wrong. This country is in trouble. To help bail it out, write Vista, Box V, Washington, D.C.
WLSFM Chicago. The Chicago Heavy.
They call it the revolution. They call it revolution, 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 revolution,
right, but you gotta be left or 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 right.
Shut me out, out of your mind.
Through the papers, killings, murders, body of an 11-year-old girl found dead in the trunk of a car, teenage girl and boyfriend found shot at a Lover's Lane parking lot, the girl shot more than a dozen times. Then there's Sharon Tate and her friends. Papers said they were brutally, savagely murdered, stabbed, cut, shot. And there's the innocent child that died in Sharon's body. And the others who didn't die, family. Lives muddled, marred, confused. What kind of a mind would appoint itself to be judge and executioner? I wonder if the Hollywood murders are some kind of sadistic, distorted strike against the establishment, you know? Because on the wall, the self-appointed judge wrote in his victim's blood, pigs, and death to the pigs. And on one of the victim's chests, the killer carved the word war. Of course, ours is not to judge whether the lives of all who died were good or bad lives. They were important lives, just because they were lives. And now they're gone. What kind of mind could justify stopping those lives? I'm really sick of the distortion and confusion in the minds of a few. And I'm sorry for the wasted lives. And so we mourn and watch.
Take a look in the mirror. Look at yourself, but don't you look too close. Cause you just might see the person boy and every girl. Denying themselves a real chance to build a better world. Dealer, dealer, strange. It's washing away on a bloody, bloody stream. Take a look at your children, for it's too late, and tell them nobody wins when the prize is hate.
Get yourself together with One Stop, 3314 West Foster Avenue in Chicago, Lipside. Stereo albums for $3.19, stereo 8-track tapes for $5.50, mono albums for $1, and 69 cents for top 40, 45. Plus tickets for all the major events with Ticketron, the electronic ticket office, for top performances with Kinetic Aragon Triangle Productions, Summer of Stars, Northbrook Sports Complex, and plus many others. All these include mugs, montage, stationery, and everything you can imagine in the way of gifts. A touch of Old Town and Downtown are at Flipside, 3314 West Foster Avenue in Chicago. The Flipside, where One Stop covers all your entertainment needs, from albums to tapes, gifts, tickets for the top show. Pick up what's new in rock: The Doors, Jeff Beck, Hendrix, Blind Faith, Three Dog Night, Led Zeppelin. Can you imagine one store having all these things for you? Well, Flipside does. At 3314 West Foster Avenue in Chicago, the greatest little record shop with the big service and selection.
You'd better mean business when you see your Chicagoland American Motors dealer about a new Javelin. You'd better be ready to swing to the sporty car that's the talk of Trans Am. You'd better not be kidding around, because your Chicagoland American Motors dealers is going to offer you a deal you can't turn down. And that includes top dollar for your trade-in, too. You'd better be ready to enjoy that groovy styling, the roomy interior that seats five, the big windows, the massive bumpers. And you'd better be ready to pick your options. Engines all the way up to 390 cubic inch V8s, power steering, power front disc brakes, automatic or four-speed stick shift, even air conditioning. Just get there soon to get the Javelin you want. Because your Chicagoland American Motors dealers means business. And at his clearance prices, those Javelins won't last long.
You can see them in Chicago at Archer Kedzie Sales at 4393 South Archer Avenue.
On WLSFM, stereo 94.7, Chicago.
Time you dress so fine, through the bumps of time in your prime. Then you, people call, say beware doll, you're bound to fall. You thought they were off, I'm kidding you. You used to laugh about everybody that was hanging out. So loud. Now you don't seem so proud about having to be scrounging your next meal. How does it feel? How does it feel? You know you only used to get juiced in it. Nobody's ever taught you how to live out on the street, and now you're gonna have to get used to it. times when they all did tricks for you. Never understood that it ain't no good. You shouldn't let other people get your kicks for you. You used to ride on a chrome horse with your diplomat, who carried on his shoulder a Siamese cat. Ain't it hard when you discover that he really wasn't
as wrong when you say you want it all.
tooth doing I've Got Enough Heartache? Seems. Here's Howard Smith.
Chuck Berry and Bill Haley are unquestionably two of the founding fathers of rock and roll, and both are involved in the current renaissance of the old sound, which has been especially big in England. Unfortunately, Berry and Haley have recently been running into one of the problems that used to plague the old rock. Back in the mid-50s, half of the fun of going to a rock and roll show, they weren't called concerts then, was the ritual of slashing your seat, destroying anything around you, and on a good night, punching out the guy sitting next to you. Now that rock has become what is often referred to as a legitimate art form, rock fans have become more genteel. But apparently, it's the old fans who still flock to see the old performers, because the Bill Haley, Chuck Berry British visit has been marred by seat-slashing and coin-throwing audiences. Their major appearance on the 19-stop tour was to have been at London's gigantic Albert Hall, but the nervous management has canceled it, and doesn't that bring it all back home?